course, yeah. Right after you're in British Boxers, we're in the Pant in Newbridge. And I'm delighted to say I've bumped into Gavin Reese, and I didn't expect this. It's a nice little bonus, this, because what a fighter. But I understand now you're really enjoying the training fighters side of things.
Yeah, it's busy training the boys like Cody Davis, Craig Evans, Jake Tinklin. You know, trying to had a good career. Been retired 5 years now, passing my knowledge on to the young boys.
Yeah. Well, you didn't just have a good career, you had an exceptional career, didn't you, really? British, European, world champion.
You're doing your research.
No, I just know.
Yeah, I won. We've got Cody Davis now fighting for a British title eliminator. Craig Evans, waiting for a date for that, both of them. So maybe by the end of the year, we have two British champions.
Yeah.
So that'll be great, like, for the gym.
Do you think that, you know, your experiences in the ring really help you when you're training a fighter in a tough spot?
Yeah, I think sometimes to get to the top level, you need to learn a bit of boxing itself at a certain level, good level, to know what the training like, the diet's like, and then what the big stage is like.
Yeah. Can you sort of think back to how this area in particular has produced some phenomenal champions, considering it's a small area? What is it in the water around here, or what is it that produces such champions?
I don't know, God knows, to be honest with you. Years ago, we had myself, Joe Calzaghe from just up the road, Bradley Price, his brothers, Nathan Cleverly, Robbie Regan, a lot of good champions now.
Enzo McInerney.
A bit further away, Swansea. I want the local area up here. Yeah. Mike's from Swansea area, so we've got Cody Davis, Craig Evans, all coming through the ranks now, so hopefully I have a few champions out of them.
Now, yeah, Cody's got a good fight coming up. It's at New York Hall. He's fighting another unbeaten prospect as well.
Yeah.
You know, why take such a risky fight going into, you know, such an early stage of his career?
Why not? You know, we've fully believed in his ability. He's 9-0, and obviously he's a British title eliminator, so to get the British title, you need to beat him in front of him. And he's the opposition, so we've been training hard. We've got another 4 weeks left, and we're fully confident the job's getting done. He's in fantastic shape in the gym, great in sparring, so looking forward to the fight.
Yeah. I know that the British title meant a lot to you. You know, it was a title that you fought for.
Yeah, should have kept it and defended it, but as a fighter and a person, you just want to keep chasing money. And when he offered you double money to fight for different fights, you just give it up now. I won it twice, gave it up twice too, but it would be nice to keep it on. I got all my belts, I won apart from the breast, so hopefully Cody can win when I keep one.
You were in some epic fights.
Yeah.
I mean, just off the top of my head, you know, I remember the one with Crawler. Fought Derry Matthews a couple of times. You've got massive international fights with people like Adrian Broner. I mean, you know, you've had a glittering career, really. Is there anything that you look back and you think, well, you would have done differently, or anything that stands out to you from your career?
I've got some regrets, but there's no point in looking back. I got 4 great kids, I'm married, got plenty of money in the bank, so what's the point in looking back with regrets? Could have walked away and winning nothing. Yeah. You know, there's people around you with great talent and they never won nothing in their career. I won everything, so...
Yeah.
To say, I'm in a good place in my life. Years ago when I was young, I probably used to drink too much and do stuff I shouldn't have been doing, but you live and learn.
Live and learn, yeah. But considering you're doing that, you still managed to win quite a few times.
Yeah.
Imagine if you did like a month.
I know. Imagine I stopped drinking for 3 weeks.
What are your recollections of winning the world title?
Blurry. My memory ain't the best. No, I got offered a chance out in Norway by Frank Warren. I was 27-0 at the time. And I obviously think I was putting it to lose, to be honest, but I went in. I won most of the rounds, found the fight quite easy, to be honest. That was probably one of the most times in my life when I actually dedicated to boxing. Stopped drinking, stopped my party lifestyle.
Yeah.
And just boxed great and won a fight symbol.
But it was an emotional night and win. You know, do you sometimes look back at it on YouTube or just sort of relive that moment?
I don't really watch boxing, to be honest, a lot. Unless say my boys in the gym or my friends, I don't really watch it, to be honest.
Really? Why is that?
Don't know. I haven't got a fucking clue. I swear.
It's alright.
I don't know. I'm a boxing fan, sort of. I like training people. I like actually getting punching people myself. But I never even wanted to study boxing. I'm a great fan of it.
Yeah. I know. I want to talk about this one fight, if you don't mind.
Yeah,
I know you lost it, but it is Adrian Broner.
You've
done so well in the early stages, though.
Yeah.
He was at the height of his powers, really.
Yeah, I know. Obviously, I was confident myself. Like I say, boxed Eddie Matthews. I knocked him out in Sheffield. I went over to France and I defended my European title against Anthony Mizash. So I was on a good run myself. I'd only lost one fight out of 35, 36, I'm not sure quite the number. But I was in good form. Went over there, probably won the first couple of rounds. And he caught me with that body shot then, I think it was round three or four.
Yeah.
And when I stuck it out the window at my sale.
Low body shot though, wasn't it, if I remember correctly?
Nah, felt fucking low. It didn't hurt, to be honest, man. You know, at the time, he was a superstar, wasn't he, at the time?
Yeah.
He was phenomenal at lightweight, so big, so strong.
Massive at lightweight.
Yeah, and it wasn't like on a British level, it once or twice. He did it 10, 15 times before, you know, the ref was jumping out, guy feel at all. But, you know, it was nice to get that stage fighting in America on the big stage. And that's what the plans have got for the boys.
You did surprise him with a few shots, though. Remember a few hooks coming from that low stance?
He surprised me with a lot fucking more.
And of course, towards the end of the career, I'm just
I keep swearing on this camera, man. This is how I speak.
That's fine, you carry on. I mean, just looking, I've just got your box record here now, just because it was an impromptu meeting.
Yeah.
But, you know, some brilliant fights. I mean, towards the end of your career, you fought a lot of the guys from the North, the Northwest as well, you know, like Derry Matthews, Anthony Crawl, that was a great fight as well. You actually ended your career with a win as well, Gary Butler.
Yeah,
but you decided to walk away at that stage of your career. Why did you decide to walk away on a win?
Well, I lost three of my last four fights, and I lost four altogether. It was just injuries plagued me towards the end. My arms are gone, my couldn't hardly. For the last fight with Gary Blackland, I didn't spar at all because obviously my arms were too bad. So I said to Gary, I'll just have this fight, get a win, and then I'll retire then. So that's what I done. A lot of people thought I'd come back, say box so good. But I'd had enough. And in a gym when you can't punch your bags and you can't pads and spar, it's just no other option, to be honest.
Mm. We're going over to see George Mazzaghi later on as well.
Yeah.
You know, do you look back at that golden era for Welsh boxing when you guys were all coming through?
Yeah.
And with fond memories.
Yeah, well, of course, we were all ruling the world. We had three or four world champions at the same time. So, you know, we had a bit of a slump for a couple of years, but we got Selby, Liam Williams, Cody Kung Fu, Craig Evans. Got a lot of good Joe Cordina flying again. Got a lot of good talent in Wales again now, so.
Yeah.
Hopefully we can get a few more world champions.
Yeah. Tell us why people should get on board with Cody then. You know, if they haven't seen him yet, why should they sort of come out and get on board with that journey?
What should I say, coach? You're a good prep, what? I don't know, he's a great kid, he's a slick southpaw. It'd be saying, people obviously don't know him very well at the moment, but the next 12 to 18 months, people will soon know who he is. I believe in that time, be on the world stage. What plans now to fight Charlie, maybe drop back down to super middleweight and win a British title. And then just keep building on that.
Just looking at him, he'd be a massive super middleweight.
He makes super middleweight early, but Che didn't want to fight super middleweight, so we agreed to fight at light heavy. But he's only like 83 kilos now. It's full of water, full of food, so he can do 77 symbol.
Yeah. It's classed as a 50-50 though, this fight, so, you know.
In whose eyes? Yours?
Well, no, in the book, in Cody's eyes.
80-20, yeah. Yeah, maybe so, but like I said, people really haven't seen the talent Cody got. And this fight, I think everyone opened their eyes and see how good he is.
Yeah, yeah. And just finally, you know, when a lot of fighters retire, you know, some of them can sort of drift off and, you know, but you seem to have fixed and you're helping the young talent coming through. I mean, is that something that means a lot to you to be able to do that?
I wouldn't call it retire, I'm busier than ever.
Yeah,
we're travelling up the country, around the country all the time. I'm in the gym every single day training people. We're up to Sheffield again tomorrow, sparring, but it's good investing some like engine to the boys. Like I say, obviously, it all makes plenty of money, and it can retire rapidly as well. So there's not a lot around this area, to be honest. There's not a lot of money outside of boxing or anywhere, really, so we'll really make money, buy a house, and live comfortably.
Well, it's brilliant to catch up with you, just bump into you. I mean, you're a fighter that I remember watching coming through as well, myself watching you, and you gave us some great nights. So thank you very much for your time, and hopefully next time we see you, can have a bit of more long one, sit down, look back over some of them fights.
Yeah, okay, no problem, thanks.
Thanks.